Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Skippy Lowe Looks at Hollywood. Today's guests are Broadway Hollywood star Robert Morse and the publisher of the Hollywood Dramalogue, Bill Bordy. And now, here he is, Hollywood's one-of-a-kind, Skippy Lowe.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Looking at Hollywood today. We have a Tony Award winner, one of my favorite Broadway stars, and he's a real superstar. Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Morse. Hello, Robert.
Nice to see you, Skippy.
How are you doing?
Well, I'm fine. I put gas in the car and drove over here. I have it parked right outside, put quarters in the meter, and I'm just glad to spend the time with you.
How to succeed in business without really trying.
That was the title.
It was a long one.
It was hard to get up on the marquee.
It took three people to put that up. One of the best shows. How long was that on Broadway?
I was very fortunate, very, very fortunate to be in a great show like that, that won the Pulitzer Prize, and of course it...
The Tony.
It had some great people associated with it, you know, the choreographer and the director. Oh my gosh, the name just went out of my mind. Bob Fosse. And of course Abe Burrows and Frank Lesser's music and... Mm-hmm. It was a lot of fun.
It's a great show.
And Rudy Valley.
Rudy Valley, yes.
And Michelle Lee, who isn't doing badly.
Was she in that?
Yes, she was in
that. She's a very talented lady.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You did also Take Me Along.
I did a show called Take Me Along. That was a musical with...
Vivian Blaine.
Walter Pigeon and Jackie Gleason and Eileen Hurley, who is in All My Children. And that was based on Ah Wilderness by Eugene O'Neill.
Great.
Directed by Peter Glanville, Robert Merrill wrote the words and the music. That was lovely.
Say Darling was with Vivian Blaine. Is that the one? Am I getting confused?
Say Darling was, that's right.
With David Wayne.
Right.
Yeah, right.
Music by Julie Stein. Comden and Green wrote the words. Directed by Abe Burrows again.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, that was a long, long, long time ago.
Not really, Robert.
No, yes.
Not really.
I'm sorry.
What are you doing now? Actually.
Right now, I'm going to say hello to my children who are watching this right at this moment, probably. I know it's going all over the country, but I know it's going into New York.
New York, Manhattan Cable.
Manhattan Cable.
On Channel D.
Channel D.
Every Saturday at 6 o'clock.
Okay, so I'd like to say hello to Robin and Andrea and Hillary, my daughters. I haven't seen them in a long time.
Three?
Thank you. Three daughters.
Oh,
I'm so
beautiful.
Happy.
And there are two in the business, you say?
Two of them are in the business. Robin, the middle daughter, is she's an understudy in Brighton Beach Memoirs.
Great show.
In fact, she's been on two or three times maybe this past week. And she's been on several times, of course, and written by Neil Simon. And then my oldest daughter, Andrea, is 21 years old, I think. And she graduated State University of New York at SUNY Purchase. And she is in New York making a living, as all young actors and actresses do before they get a job to support themselves.
Is that what you did when you were
slinging hash or whatever one does?
Robert Morse, how did it all become about you becoming a Broadway?
Well,
to get to Broadway,
I was a Fuller Brush man. I worked at Schraff's.
Did you really?
I parked cars at Tavern on the Green. I had lots of odd jobs before I, you know, got my first break. I went to the American Theater Wing. And from there, I...
You're from Massachusetts. Newton? Is that right?
Yes, I'm from Massachusetts, Newton.
Newton? Yes. It's a good town, Newton.
Yes, it's a good town.
Is that
town.
Where you studied in Massachusetts, in Boston or somewhere? Or singing, dancing?
Not really. I mean, I grew up there, and I went to school there. I went to Newton High School, but... And as a child, I always wanted to be an actor.
You always wanted to be. That was your desire.
I think so.
Yeah.
I mean, I used to go to the movies and dream of, you know... Gene Kelly and Ray Bolger and Peter Lawford and Good News and all the musicals and all that sort of thing, and hope some. And I'd come home and play Alan Ladd and you know, put on trench coats and I had a tremendous imagination, always in some sort of fantasy land, and I wanted to entertain. I mean, I had a feeling that I wanted to act or be on a stage and be in a book show and do musicals and things like that, and I'm very fortunate and grateful to have been in five musicals on Broadway.
Five?
Yes, I think
How
it's
many
five.
Broadway shows have
Maybe
you
Maybe six.
Six. How many shows have you done, Robert? You've
oh,
done
my
Sugar.
Goodness.
Was that on Broadway, Sugar,
Matchmaker,
too.
Say Darling, Take Me Along,
Sugar.
How to Succeed, Sugar, So Long, 174th Street.
You did a lot, yes.
And, of course, toured the country in many of those shows, and I've done repertory theater, and I've done theater all over the country, and I've done dinner theater, and I've done TV shows, and so I'm just happy to...
Are you doing something now? Hollywood. We're in Hollywood now.
We are in Hollywood now.
You miss New York, do you?
I'm preparing a show. I've got to do a nice play that I found.
A play?
A good play, and we're going
not
to...
Not a musical?
No, it's going to Traverse City, Michigan for 2 weeks, and if it works out, there's thought that it might go on, but one day at a time, we'll see. First, I've got to learn the words.
Could you tell us
what
the title?
It wouldn't mean much to anybody.
Really?
It's called Duke.
You know,
it doesn't mean anything at the moment, but it's something that I'm working on, and that's
You're
nice.
Going to plan to take it to Broadway?
Well, I plan to learn the words and take it to Traverse City, Michigan.
Michigan.
And then if it's good, and like I think it is, and other people think it is, it might have a life further than that.
Mm-hmm. I see.
Yes.
Yes. Tell me something, Robert Morse. Hollywood. What do you find about Hollywood, the difference between Hollywood and New York?
Well,
I mean, you're a Broadway star, theater to movies, really. I mean, you've done a lot of films, I know, but... You're really theater.
The difference, well, I guess the difference is, you know, everybody gets in a car out here, sort of closes the door.
True.
And then you go in that little bubble of a car, and you drive somewhere else to see some people. And you don't, in New York, one is always passing or walking or, I don't know, it's a lot more exercise, I find.
I like New York.
A lot more walking.
I prefer walking.
Here, there's if you want to get from one place to another, you get in a car.
And a freeway.
And
especially,
a freeway,
yes. Especially, I have to sit in the back seat.
Right.
Matchmaking. Is that right? Matchmaker.
The Matchmaker.
Yes, you did that movie.
Yes, I did the movie The Matchmaker with Shirley Booth, Shirley MacLaine, Tony Perkins, and Paul Ford.
That's a great film. You were the only original, you did it on Broadway, you were the only one that, from the really show that came to Hollywood.
Yes. Yeah.
You're the only one.
I don't even remember the year.
You don't?
It was a long time ago.
Poor Dad, Oh Dad, is that the name of
the
show?
Oh Dad, Poor Dad, Mama's Hung You in the Closet.
Yeah. What was that about? I don't remember
that. What was that about? Yeah. About an hour and a half. it was a sort of a black comedy on Broadway at one time, and they put it into a movie. It was with Rosalind Russell, and to explain the ramifications of that movie would be like explaining the Brothers Karamazov in a minute here, you know.
You know. Robert, tell me something. A singer, a dancer, did you study?
Oh, yes.
You did study?
Oh, yes.
Singing, dancing, music?
I take singing. I have a very bad cold today, and I apologize to the people out there. This isn't
well, it's damp today.
No, I've just got a little cold, and I'm sorry. But anyways, I took dance lessons at Luigi's in New York.
Luigi's.
And I studied with Lee Strasberg for 2 years.
You did?
Yes. And
I would never think you would study with Strasberg. Why?
I don't know.
I don't know. You're more musical comedy than studying with a method actor.
Well, actually, when I got my
first... He is a method actor.
Actually, when I first got my start in New York, I did mostly dramas. I worked with Dustin Hoffman in Naked Cities and did a lot of that type of work. It was more dramatic. Most of my early life before The Matchmaker was, until TV around that time, was not necessarily musical. My first musical was Take Me Along.
Take
but before
me.
That, I did... mostly dramatic shows.
I see. You're a fine actor. You really are.
Well,
you just did a film on TV just, a couple weeks ago.
That's right.
That was a good movie. I thought it was excellent.
ABC Movie of the Week. And,
what was the title of that? I forgot.
The Calendar Girl Murders.
Calendar Girl Murders,
yes.
Right.
I didn't write it, but I was in it. And, I've done Movies of the Week and The Fall Guy and... Dukes of Hazzard and things like that.
That's what you're here doing now in Hollywood.
I'm doing whatever one does.
I see. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I have here? I have a gentleman right now I'm going to bring to... I'd like you to meet. He's the man who's responsible for this wonderful paper called Drama Log here in Hollywood. And it is a casting sheet. It is for young people who don't know where to go.
I think it's more than a casting sheet. It has some of the finest interviews and has a lot of things of everything that's happening around town in so many ways, in San Francisco, in Paris, in France, in New York. And all over the area, I think it's something that every actor reads or picks up because it's probably one of the... It's put together so well, it's colorful, and it has... It shows you how to get along out here.
It does,
It helps you how to get along.
In fact,
I have a feeling that you even advertise in it.
I do a showcase.
So Drama Log is, like you think of Variety and you think of other... This stands on its own. It's... It's a very fine magazine.
I'd like you to meet him right
I
now.
I would like to meet
him. His name is Bill Brody, the Why publisher not? Of Drummerlog. Bill
yes.
Bordy.
Almost.
Bordy,
almost
Bordy, Bordy, Bordy. How are you, Bill? It is Bordy, right.
Almost. Oh, that's a great plug. And it's not a sheet anymore. It was a sheet many, many years ago.
It was?
Now it's a full.
It's a full.
It's a full-fledged newspaper. Look, we even have two front pages. Look at that.
A sheet is something different.
Yeah, well, when Drummerlog started, it was a sheet.
It was.
Because we just had.
When did it all start?
Well, actually, that was a second step.
When
the first step, 15 years ago, we had just celebrated our 15th anniversary, as a matter of fact, March 15th, the Ides of March.
Congratulations.
And the first couple years, it wasn't a publication at all. It was a telephone answering service.
That's what it
you
was.
Dialed the number, and you got a recording of my voice, and my voice told you who was casting or who was auditioning the next day or the next couple days for shows, you see. And we did that for about 2.5 years, and then we got so many people calling. I had to go and start printing the thing. So I started printing it as a casting sheet. That came out twice a week. And then that grew from the casting sheet to a legal size folded in half, then to 8.5 by 11 folded in opened and filled and adding pages and to what it is.
What's the what is the subscription today, and where does it go?
We sell just about the same amount as the Daily Variety, and they've been around for 50
really?
Years. Of course, they're daily. I'm only weekly. I come out once a week. But I know we're at least the amount that the Hollywood Reporter sells, and the Variety, they might sell maybe 2,000 more than us. But we're getting there. We've only been around 15 years.
So for young people that come to Hollywood, that's what they
this
should
do? This is the paper to get, because that's why I started the paper many, many years ago, or started the service before it became the paper, because I was an actor, I had training for an actor, and couldn't wait
you
to get out.
You were an actor, Bill Bordy?
Yeah, and I still am. I mean, once an actor, always an actor, you
and
know.
You, and I'm
not a working actor, but I'm an actor, you know.
You wanted to be an actor.
Sure.
Yes,
I came out here ready to break into the movies, and there was no, I had no way of knowing how to do it, how to go about it, and that's the problem with most kids coming out today.
There's no way to go. Right.
Is that how you got the idea for Drummerlog? How did it start in your head?
Actually, the idea.
Were you a writer?
No. Well, no, I hate to write. You get in life what you resist. I hate to write. You know, I'm illiterate. What am I doing with a newspaper? But actually, I'm not really illiterate. And it just evolved into that because we needed the service. I started the service. And initially people were saying, how are you making money on it, because it was a free service, and I said, I'm not. Somehow, someday, this will evolve into something, and I'll make a living on it. So now I'm doing more than making a living. I'm doing very, very
well.
You're
doing very well. How many people do you have working for you?
Oh, see, not a big staff. People walk in sometime, and they look around and say, this is all there is? But we have a very marvelous, fine-honed staff, and they all...
Who's your editor?
My editor, I used to be the editor, and then a few years back I gave that away to my associate editor that time. He became editor, and now he's editor-in-chief.
Right.
He has the whole say of the copy that goes in there, because I'm trying to get away a little bit more doing some other adventures.
What's
his name is Lee Melville.
Melville,
And
you have a wonderful woman there.
Polly Warfield.
Warfield. She's
been around.
Have you met her?
No.
She's wonderful. Yeah. She's a wonderful critic here in town.
Yeah.
She's usually right on the button.
Right.
She really is right on the button, Robert.
Right. Because since the casting, of course, we have grown into, we review almost all of the theater in town, all of the professional theater.
Right.
When I'm professional, I hate to use that word because it's been overused, but by professional we mean equity or equity waiver theater, theater that has been... sanctioned by the Actors Stage Union, which is Equity.
Yes.
And we last year alone we covered we reviewed over 700 plays. Mm-hmm. So there is that much theater going on
in
Los
in
Angeles.
LA.
Now,
there is,
that's not
yes.
counting community theater or college theater. That's
really
strictly
is.
Professional theater, which means we cover about 14, 15 plays a week.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's quite a bit.
You did mention that this might go to...
To New York. Yeah, I'm thinking...
Drummerlog is going to New York?
Fellow who was my editor many, many years ago when we first started out, he was a young fellow, his name was Doug Cole. He had to go to Broadway to start, he wanted to produce some Broadway shows. So he did produce a couple off-Broadway shows, one's called Trixie True and a couple other ones, it's terrible, I should really remember. And again, he hated movies, and you get in life what you resist. He wound up working on a lot of the movies that were in New York. So we've been talking together. Now he's ready to do a New York edition of Dramalogue. Mm-hmm. So I may go back, I feel, sometime this year and get the whole thing rolling. Uh-huh. So we'll have the Hollywood Dramalogue and the New York Dramalogue. And next year, the year after, we'll have the Parisian Dramalogue.
You'll have one. You'll have one.
Dramalogue à Paris. Yeah,
you'll have one probably in Dallas and Chicago. I mean, the industry is spreading.
Yeah,
out.
Well, it is.
Yes, it is.
It is. Yeah, especially in Texas now. There's an awful lot.
Bill Bordy.
Yes, sir.
You were in the circus. You studied in the circus at Sarasota.
Well, okay.
Didn't you?
I didn't actually study in the circus. I went to the Ringling School of Art, fresh out of high school. Uh-huh. I was going to. I studied to be a commercial artist, which came in handy later when I started doing Dramalogue. Uh-huh. I did all the layout and everything.
Yes, right.
And we had animal drawing classes and landscape classes at the Ringling Brothers winter quarters.
Yes, right.
And I went there and met the people and just. Mm-hmm. It was like home. I knew, you know, they were all European, and my parents are European.
And you also MC'd,
and I just
MC shows for strips.
That was much later.
Much later.
But in the circus. It was kind of funny because I almost joined the circus.
Did you really?
I was going to be an elephant boy, and I was starting to work out in the parallel bars and the trampoline. And
every kid has that.
You know, no, and I was going to, and then I met the chef, and he was so dirty, and I said I could never eat the food, and off I went. You know,
Robert, did you have any desire to join the circus really?
Often.
When you were a kid?
Oh no, I still do.
You do
today. Uh-huh. Often when I feel a little blue, I go, I think I'll join the circus. I mean, or something.
Well,
like,
it
I
is. It's
run
an
away.
Exciting life.
You know, I'm putting makeup on.
It's another. It's another show business, isn't it?
But
like
it is.
Jimmy
it's
Stewart
always show,
and Hyde.
It's another type of show business.
Well, that's I would much rather have done what Bobby was doing, getting in the films and doing Broadway. But still, I was in my show business, almost the circus, and then.
And what about
and staging
what
the
about
shows
now? And what are you doing now?
Well,
what are your aspirations?
I'm finally doing it. After all these years, I'm finally doing some movies. I did a few over the years.
You're going to do films.
Yeah, I did a few. I mean, as an actor, I think I've probably done more films in Hollywood that have never been released, that have been sitting on the shelves, you know. Maybe one of these days they'll get out, but I'm actually producing and directing and writing and acting in one right now that called Twilight Blues. So before I fall apart too badly, I want to do. And then I did a French movie last year too.
What's your advice
in
for
French?
Young people to
in French, not French, not like not like dirty or anything.
Have you ever been to Paris? Have you?
Yeah, I lived there for a while.
I did too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I did too. I entertained the troops there. You were an MC. Getting back, you were an MC and.
In burlesque.
In burlesque, yeah.
Yeah, there I was 19 years old, and I was the world's your oyster, and you can do anything.
And also, private detective, I understand.
That was later.
Would you believe him? A private man of all trades.
In
really.
Fact, I played private.
I forgot
a lot of those old cheapy movies.
You mentioned that you're in burlesque. I completely forgot, and I wonder why. I was with Carol Channing. In Sugar Babies.
Oh,
that's right. Sugar Babies. That's
right.
Sugar Babies. Yes.
So burlesque
that,
is
that is it.
Burlesque is a lot of fun.
Yes.
I mean that really that I all the routines in the burlesque shows.
I wish I could have seen you and her doing
it. Sugar Babies.
Because I have seen Mickey
Mickey
times. Like I know him. I don't know Mickey.
Yeah, well, it's a lot of fun putting on an old hat and being crazy.
Yeah. Well, I can just imagine. The opening of the one scene where Mickey or you, I've seen Mickey and I you too. When he has the back and turns around, he's in drag. Yes, you know, and it's so funny. And I envisioned you doing it when I saw him too. You know, so.
Did you do it in L.A., Robert? Or
no, I did Sugar Babies in Texas, Dallas, and St. Louis Municipal Opera, and Boston.
How was Carol Channing to work? I mean, you worked with her, but how? What kind of a lady really she is? What kind of a lady?
What was Carol Channing like to work with?
Yeah.
That's a very good question. No.
Could she be anything other than what she is?
No. What kind of a lady really she is to work with? Robert?
Joan Rivers. What are you going to? You want to say something bad?
Joan Rivers?
No, you want him to say something bad?
No, I don't want him to say nothing bad. Evidently, he won't answer me.
No.
He won't answer me then.
No.
So she's a great lady. She's a great performer. Like Joan Rivers, you mean Joan Rivers, what I'm going to say about Joan Rivers? I think she gets beyond the bone. She just carries away too much for me.
Yeah.
But Bill Bordy, what would you tell our young people when they come to Hollywood? What would they do?
Buy Dramalogue. No, seriously.
True.
That's really the only way to go. That's the great thing about the Dramalogue. When an aspiring actor or singer or dancer or technician comes to town, that's where that person can go. Pick
get
up
all
a copy
the information.
Of the Dramalogue, and they'll find out exactly what's happening. Mm-hmm. And the next day, they should be able to go out and get an interview or at least send a picture and resume.
Do they
somewhere.
Get jobs?
Yeah, they get jobs.
Carol Channing.
Yeah, Carol Channing, yes.
Carol Channing probably loves more than anything else to be on a stage and entertaining and giving to an audience. I mean, absolutely, I haven't met anybody as obsessed with anybody that I've ever worked with. That, well, I mean it in a loving way, that she just loves to be on a stage and doing it the way she feels. And she just loves an audience. And she seems to, that's something that's quite admirable, you know. Mm-hmm. Some of us get tired or don't want to do a show every night or feel that. She gets there at about 3 p.m. and already has the next day planned.
Boy.
And she loves the theater. And she's something.
She's a great lady. I met her in Kansas City, Missouri once. She was wonderful. She came to a club where I was working. I was working a club in Kansas City, and she came in. She's a great supporter for entertainers.
Well, Carol Lawrence took over the part for a while, too. Was that with you?
I believe that was in New York.
Now when you were with her, right.
Carol Lawrence took it over. Joey Bishop has done it. Other people have done different parts when someone has gone on a vacation or been hurt for a while.
Robert Morse, do you really miss New York?
Oh, gosh.
Tell me.
If I could be in a play right now, it would be wonderful. Well, you know, I love the stage.
Of course.
But I'm so grateful for whatever happens in my life, my children, and I'm happy in so many ways. Uh-huh. And, you know, I don't feel I want to attain anything or need anything or, you know, that kind of stuff. I'm just working with a lot of people and helping a lot of people, and they're helping me, and whatever happens is fine. You know, I'm very grateful to be working, that's all.
But you are going to be doing Sugar again, aren't you?
I might be doing Sugar with Larry Kurt at the Houston Civic Light Opera.
Larry Kurt, my
and,
God.
Well, Houston is the next L.A., New York.
It is, really?
Houston. I mean,
Houston?
It is. I mean, it's almost the three cities now, just about the...
It has a nice ring to it, the Houston Civic Light Opera. I mean, that's pretty nice. Anytime I can get on a stage and go, hello!
What would you tell the young people that come to come to Hollywood or New York? How they should prepare themselves, Robert?
Wow, that is a tough, you know, it is a hard question to ask, because I often do get letters, you know, I wish to do this, where should I study, where should I go, or what should I do? And it's very hard to give advice to a young actor what they should do when they want a specific. And I guess all one can say is, if it, within their heart they want something, and if they want to work at it, you know, there are classes to be taken, there are dance classes to be taken, there's all sorts of things that they can get involved with, and get involved with other people their age, and then they will find their way within the people of their own age, and take, you know, and pursue it from there. But it's a tough life, and but if they want it, and you know, I don't mean it's a tough line. You know what I'm saying. It has its difficulties, like anything.
Yes.
But if they want it bad enough, and if they have they want to just go with it, do it. You know?
Robert Morse, is there a lady in your in life right now?
A lady in my life?
Yes, I like.
Oh, certainly.
Is there?
Yes. There's.
That's, you look so happy. That's why I just felt it.
There is a lady.
There is.
Certainly.
Is she an actress, or is she in the business, or?
She's a friend of mine.
She's a friend?
She's a lady in my life.
She's special.
I got lots of nice ladies, lots of friends, and lots of people around.
You look very happy, Robert. He looks so young, doesn't he?
Yeah.
And never grow old, Robert
Morse.
Well,
the truth of the matter is that I can't, I just, you know, whatever
the
way I look is okay. I guess it's, you know, no drink and no pills. What can I tell you?
That's wonderful. And don't drink, don't smoke. That's marvelous. You smoke?
Right. What?
Cigarettes?
Once in a while.
But you look wonderful.
But the other step I don't do.
That's great, Robert.
It's rust.
It's a spiritual, thing. You can see. And how about you in Hollywood? What's happened for Bill Bordy in Hollywood?
Well, as I said, right now, I'm still shooting Twilight Blues. Uh-huh. Hope to have that finished.
Are you married, Bill?
No.
You're not
married? No. I've got some in my life right now.
But you have a sister that runs your business for you?
Well, she doesn't run it. She handles...
her name is Pearl.
Pearl, right. She handles the money aspect of it. She handles all the books and the boring stuff.
The boring.
But she loves that, you say. Right.
See.
And as I say, I'm just trying to get away from the drama log as much as I can to pursue my other pursuits. I also am one of the owners of the Music Connection, which is a drama lodge for...
Music Connection?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Which is like a drama lodge for musicians.
Yes, right, for musicians.
And I'll be getting a little more involved with them again, too. And a lady friend of mine, two lady friends of mine, just started a cosmetic business, so I'm involved with that. So I always have
Music Connection. Robert, Music Connection is a place, a paper like the Drama Log, but it's for musicians. It's for bands, rock bands and stuff, right?
You're a man for all seasons.
Yeah.
I advertise in that paper also. I have rock bands.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
I've been doing a talent showcase in town for like 9 years, and I've been advertising in his paper, getting my people, young singers and young comedians, and they come and audition for me. And I really want to thank you very, very much for getting those people for me.
Well,
and your
paper has
really helped.
You've been doing the showcases now how many years?
Nine years since I got back from the Far East.
Yeah,
I was entertaining in the Far East.
Yeah.
I was in show business for 35 years, and all of a sudden I decided to come to Hollywood and run a talent showcase.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been doing it, and it's been I've been enjoying it, helping young people, getting up there performing. Robert Morse, I want to thank you. You're a very special person.
Thank you. Thank you for having
great
me.
Great talent.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Skippy Lowe. We have been looking at Hollywood. Thank you.
Comden and Green wrote the words, directed by Abe Burrows again. And, of course, that was a long, long, long time ago.
Not really, Robert.
No, yes.
Not really.
I'm sorry.
What are you doing now, actually?
Right now, I'm going to say hello to my children who are watching this right at this moment, probably. I know it's going all over the country, but I know it's going into New York.
New York, Manhattan Cable.
Manhattan Cable.
On Channel D.
Channel D.
Every Saturday at 6 o'clock.
Okay, so I'd like to say hello to Robin and Andrea. And Hillary, my daughters. I haven't seen them in a long time.
Three?
Thank you. Three daughters.
Oh,
I'm so happy.
And there are two in the business, you say?
Two of them are in the business.
Sure.
Robin, the middle daughter, is she's an understudy in Brighton Beach Memoirs.
Great show.
In fact, she's been on two or three times maybe this past week. And she's been on several times, of course, and written by Neil Simon. And then my oldest daughter, Andrea, is 21 years old, I think, and she graduated State University of New York at SUNY Purchase, and she is in New York making a living, as all young actors and actresses do before they get a job to support themselves.
Is that what you did when you
slinging hash or whatever one does?
Robert Morse, how did it all become about you becoming a Broadway?
Well,
to get to Broadway,
I was a Fuller Brush man. I worked at Schraff's.
Did you really?
I parked cars at Tavern on the Green. I had lots of odd jobs before I, you know, got my first break. I went to the American Theater Wing, and from there I.
You're from Massachusetts, Newton. Is that right?
Yes, I'm from Massachusetts, Newton.
Newton. Yes, it's a good town, Newton.
Yes, it's a good town.
Is that
town.
Where you studied in Massachusetts, in Boston or somewhere? Singing, dancing?
Not really. I mean, I grew up there, and I went to school there. I went to Newton High School, but and as a child, I always wanted to be an actor.
You always wanted to be. That was your desire.
I think so.
Yeah.
I mean, I used to go to the movies and dream of, you know, Gene Kelly and Ray Bolger and Peter Lawford and Good News and all the musicals and all that sort of thing, and hope some. And I'd come home and play Alan Ladd, and you know, put on trench coats and. I had a tremendous imagination, always in some sort of fantasy land, and I wanted to entertain. I mean, I had a feeling that I wanted to act or be on a stage and be in a book show and do musicals and things like that, and I'm very fortunate and grateful to have been in.
Remember
what
that
was that about? Yeah. About an hour and a half. it was a sort of a black comedy on Broadway at one time, and they put it into a movie. It was with Rosalind Russell, and to explain the ramifications of that movie would be like explaining the Brothers Karamazov in a minute here, you know. You know.
Robert, tell me something. A singer, a dancer, did you study?
Oh, yes.
You did study?
Oh, yes.
Singing, dancing,
I take singing. I have a very bad cold today, and I apologize to the people out there. This isn't
well, it's damp today.
No, I've just got a little cold, and I'm sorry. But anyways, I took dance lessons at Luigi's in New York.
Luigi's.
And I studied with Lee Strasberg for 2 years.
You did?
Yes. And
now, I would never think you would study with Strasberg. Why?
I don't know.
I don't know. You're more musical comedy than studying with a method actor.
Well, actually, when I got my
first... He is a method actor.
Actually, when I first got my start in New York, I did mostly dramas. I worked with Dustin Hoffman in Naked Cities and did a lot of that type of work. It was more dramatic. Or most of my early life before The Matchmaker was until TV and around that time was not necessarily musical. Mm-hmm. My first musical was Take Me Along. But before that, I did... mostly dramatic shows.
I see. You're a fine actor. You really are. Wow. You just did a film on TV just a couple weeks ago.
That's right.
That was a good movie. I thought it was excellent.
ABC Movie of the Week.
And, yeah, what was the title of that? I forgot.
The Calendar Girl Murders.
Calendar Girl Murders,
yes.
Right.
I didn't write it, but I was in it. And, you know, I've done Movies of the Week and The Fall Guy and Dukes of Hazzard and things like that.
That's what you're here doing now in Hollywood.
I'm... You know, doing whatever one does.
I see. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I have here? I have a gentleman right now I'm going to bring to... I'd like you to meet. He's the man who's responsible for this wonderful paper called Drama Log here in Hollywood. And it is a casting sheet. It is for young people who don't know where to go.
I think it's more than a casting sheet. It has some of the finest interviews and has a lot of things of everything that's happening around town in so many ways, in San Francisco and Paris and France and New York. Uh-huh. And all over the area, I think it's something that every actor reads or picks up because it's probably one of the... It's put together so well, it's colorful, and it has... It shows you how to get along out here.
It does,
it helps you how to get along.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Skippy Lowe Looks at Hollywood. Today's guests are Broadway Hollywood star Robert Morse and the publisher of the Hollywood Dramalogue, Bill Bordy. And now, here he is, Hollywood's one-of-a-kind, Skippy Lowe.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Looking at Hollywood Today. We have a Tony Award winner, one of my favorite Broadway stars, and he's a real superstar. Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Morse. Hello, Robert.
Nice to see you, Skippy.
How
Thank
are
you,
you doing?
For having... Well, I'm fine. I put gas in the car and drove over here. I have it parked right outside, put quarters in the meter, and I'm just glad to spend the time with you.
How to succeed in business without really trying.
That was the title.
Is that
it was
the
a
term?
Long one. It was hard to get up on the marquee.
Believe me.
It took
me,
three people to put that up.
One of the best shows. How long was that on Broadway?
I was very fortunate, very, very fortunate to be in a great show like that. That won the Pulitzer Prize, and of course it...
The Tony.
It had some great people associated with it, you know, the choreographer and the director. Oh my gosh, the name just went out of my mind. Bob Fosse.
Bob Fosse.
And, and of course Abe Burrows and Frank Lesser's music and... Mm-hmm. It was a lot of fun.
It's a great show.
And Rudy Valli.
Rudy Valli, yes.
And Michelle Lee, who isn't doing badly.
Was she in that?
Yes, she was in
that. I love her. She's a very talented lady.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You did also Take Me Along.
I did a show called Take Me Along. That was a musical with...
Vivian Blaine.
Walter Pidgeon and Jackie Gleason and Eileen Hurley, who is in All My Children. And that was based on Ah, Wilderness by Eugene O'Neill.
Great.
And directed by Peter Glanville, Robert Merrill wrote the words and the music. That was lovely.
Say Darling was with Vivian Blaine. Is that the one? Am I getting confused?
Say Darling was, that's right.
With that David Wayne.
Right.
Yeah, right.
Music by Julie Stein. Five musicals on Broadway.
Five.
Yes, I think
how
it's
five. How many Broadway shows have
maybe
you done?
Maybe six.
Six. How many shows have you done, Robert? You've done
my
Sugar.
Goodness.
Was that on Broadway, Sugar,
Matchmaker,
too?
Say, Darling, Take Me Along,
Sugar.
How to Succeed, Sugar, So Long, 174th Street.
You did a lot, yes.
And, of course, toured the country in many of those shows, and I've done repertory theater, and I've done theater all over the country, and I've done dinner theater, and I've done TV shows, and so I'm just happy to...
Are you doing something now? We're in Hollywood now.
We are in Hollywood now.
You miss New York, do you?
I'm preparing a show. I've got to do a nice play that I found.
A play?
A good play, and we're going
not
to
a musical?
No, it's going to Traverse City, Michigan for 2 weeks, and if it works out, there's thought that it might go on, but one day at a time, we'll see. First, I've got to learn the words.
Could you tell us
what
the title?
It wouldn't mean much to anybody.
Really?
It's called Duke.
You know,
it doesn't mean anything at the moment, but it's something that I'm working on, and that's
you're
nice.
You're going to plan to take it to Broadway?
Well, I plan to learn the words and take it to Traverse City, Michigan.
Michigan.
And then if it's good, and like I think it is, and other people think it is, it might have a life further than that.
Mm-hmm. I see.
Yes.
Yes. Tell me something, Robert Morse. Hollywood. What do you find about Hollywood, the difference between Hollywood and New York?
Well,
I mean, you're a Broadway star, theater to movies, really. I mean, you've done a lot of films, I know, but you're really theater.
The difference, well, I guess the difference is, you know, everybody gets in a car out here, sort of closes the door.
True.
And then you go in that little bubble of a car, and you drive somewhere else to see some people, and you don't, New York, one is always passing or walking or, I don't know, it's a lot more exercise, I find.
I like New York.
A lot more walking.
I prefer walking.
Here, there's if you want to get from one place to another, you get in a car.
And a freeway.
And
especially,
a freeway, yes.
Especially I have to sit in the back seat.
Right.
Matchmaking. Is that right? Matchmaker.
The Matchmaker.
Yes, you did that movie.
Yes, I did the movie The Matchmaker with Shirley Booth, Shirley MacLaine, Tony Perkins, and Paul Ford.
That's a great film. You're the only original, you did it on Broadway, you're the only one that, from the really show that came to Hollywood.
Yeah.
You're the only one.
I don't even remember the year.
You don't?
It was a long time ago.
Poor Dad, Oh Dad, is that the name of
the show? Oh Dad, Poor Dad, Mama's Hung You in the Closet.
Yeah. What was that about? I don't remember. He is the
In fact, I have a feeling that you even advertise in it.
I do a showcase.
So Dramalog is, like you think of Variety and you think of other, this stands on its own. It's it's a very fine magazine.
I'd like you to meet him right now,
I would like to meet
him. His name is Bill Brody, the publisher of Dramalog. Bill Brody.
Bordy,
how are you, Bill? It is Bordy, right.
Almost. Oh, that's a great plug. And it's not a sheet anymore. It was a sheet many, many years ago.
It was?
Now it's a full... It's a full-fledged newspaper. Look, we even have two front pages. Look at that.
A sheet is something different.
Yeah, well, when Dramalog started, it was a sheet.
It was,
because we just had...
When did it all start?
Well, actually, that was a second step.
When
the first step, 15 years ago, we had just celebrated our 15th anniversary, as a matter of fact, March 15th, the Ides of March.
Congratulations.
And the first couple years, it wasn't a publication at all. It was a telephone answering service. You dialed the number, and you got a recording of my voice, and my voice told you who was casting or who was auditioning the next day or the next couple days for shows, you see. And we did that for about 2.5 years, and then we got so many people calling. I had to go and start printing the thing. So I started printing it as a casting sheet came out twice a week, and then that grew from the casting sheet to a legal size folded in half, then to 8.5 by 11 folded in opened and filled and adding pages and to what it is.
What's the what is the subscription today, and where does it go?
We sell just about the same amount as the Daily Variety, and they've been around for 50 years. Of course, they're daily. I'm only weekly. I come out once a week, but I know we're at least the amount that the Hollywood Reporter sells, and the Variety, they might sell maybe 2,000 more than us. But we're getting there. We've only been around 15 years.
So for young people that come to Hollywood. That's what they
this
should
is the paper to get, because that's why I started the paper many, many years ago, or started the service before it became the paper, because I was an actor, I had training for an actor, and couldn't wait
you
to get out.
You were an actor, Bill Bordy?
Yeah, and I still am. I mean, once an actor, always an actor, you
and
know.
You, and I'm
not a working actor, but I'm an actor, you know.
You wanted to be an actor.
Sure.
Yes,
I came out here ready to break into the movies, and there was no, I had no way of knowing how to do it, how to go about it, and that's the problem with most kids coming out today.
They don't know where to go.
There's no...